Introducing first, the challenger from Toronto, Ontario, Canada, weighing 250 pounds, he is the Rated R Superstar, Edge. And his opponent from Death Valley, weighing 299 pounds, he is the current World Heavyweight Champion, The Undertaker!
Did I just see The Undertaker mouth the words, "I'm going to hurt you," to Edge? If so, keep in mind, The Undertaker is no maker of idle threats. This is a promise.
It is for the World Heavyweight Championship. The six-time world champion, The Undertaker, versus the four-time world champion, Edge. And one of the reasons The Undertaker said he's gonna hurt Edge is, look at what these two men have been through over the past year. At every turn, Edge has been a thorn in The Undertaker's side. It began last May when Edge cashed in Money in the Bank, picking the bones of a fallen Undertaker to win the world title. Edge cost The Undertaker the championship at Survivor Series inside Hell in a Cell when Edge was camouflaged as a cameraman, and then he won the championship at Armageddon in a triple threat match.
Before WrestleMania, Edge was riding on an emotional high because he'd never actually lost to The Undertaker. We'll have to see what it has done to Edge emotionally to succumb to the devastating submission hold of The Undertaker.
Nick, that brings up a good point. It's not like Edge has never beaten The Undertaker before. He's only lost to him once. So psychologically, Edge knows that he can beat the dead man.
Psychologically, he knows that he has beaten him in the past, but I really have to wonder, that's a devastating loss to suffer, the one he did last month, because Michael, unlike most submission holds employed by excellent, great WWE superstars, there's no escape from that hold. There's no gutting it out, there's no courage factor. Once it's locked on, essentially, as far as I can tell, the match is over.
Talk strategy in this matchup, Nick. First to The Undertaker. I guess more of the same here. Try to overpower Edge. And for Edge, it's to look for an opportunity, since he is the ultimate opportunist, to find that one opening that gives him the upper hand in this match.
Edge needs to strike first. He needs to be the guy with the first major offense to get his mind right, to make him understand that, yes, those victories over Undertaker were no fluke. He's done it before. He can do it again. But it won't happen if Undertaker has his way like this.
Edge has got to stay away from the power game and from the big strikes of the world champion.
Well, that seems to be the problem, Michael. The Undertaker has just so many tools in his shed. Not only, as you've said, is he probably the greatest pure striker in WWE history, he's got so many ways to hurt you.
Well, it's the adaptation and the evolution of The Undertaker over the years. This is a much different Undertaker than the man you battled a number of years ago.
It sure is. At the time I took on The Undertaker, he had been dominant for several years, employing a combination of both physical power and psychological intimidation. And since then, seeming to defy both logic and Mother Nature, he has gotten stronger and faster, adding speed to his repertoire, and now the hold that no one seems able to counter.
Much more cerebral at times in the ring, and of course that triangle-like choke submission hold The Undertaker is employed. There's so many men here in World Wrestling Entertainment.
As far as the hopes of WWE superstars go, that hold of The Undertaker's has to be something of a death sentence. Because no one can get out of it. A long time ago, maybe 19 years, in a little apartment in Montgomery, Exotic Adrian Street placed me in a hold that I would describe as being excruciating and inescapable. Michael, I lived in fear of repeating that moment for 19 years. It's still in the back of my mind. Now, Edge's fear is only 1 month removed. It's gotta be in the forefront.
And Edge, physically intimidating there. It's a baseball slide, and suddenly, the champion is in trouble. Remember the injured back. Remember what the back has been through over the past few months as that spine crashed into the barricade.
Oh!
not affecting the champion there. And it's Edge's back. His spine to steel.
And when spine meets steel, the spine does not often win, which is the case with that devastating Batista bomb. One of the most cringe-inducing moments I've ever seen, a moment that takes somebody who's been in the ring and makes him literally jump up in fear for 1 minute.
Punishing assault so far for the world champion. And remember the words uttered at the beginning of this matchup, directed to Edge from The Undertaker. I'm going to hurt you. And that has been the game plan by the dead man from the get-go. A
lot of WWE superstars talk trash. Often they back it up. Undertaker is a man of few words, but when he speaks, we need to listen.
The Undertaker is 16-0 at WrestleMania. That one stat speaks for itself. You don't have to say anything else. Referee Charles Robinson has begun the count at a count of three.
Because a count out can end this match. That is not what Edge wants to see, as he dashes hopes, but it's not the way Undertaker wants to win either. He wants to inflict damage, he wants to injure Edge.
Title will not change hands on a count out if it was The Undertaker who was to be counted out.
Ooh.
And this is such vintage Undertaker, using the apron of the ring as a weapon as he lays his opponent's body prone, and then breaks the count as he looks to inflict more punishment.
This is not a place that Edge wants to be. Nothing good can happen here.
300 pounds!
Down across the throat. How much can a human body take? There's a whiplash effect. The weight of The Undertaker, his leg coming down across, but it seems oddly enough that The Undertaker having trouble recuperating from his own move.
Well, we talked about it earlier. You saw Undertaker go to the small of his back. That back just two nights ago slammed into his steel steps and maybe tightening up at this. What a matchup! Undertaker, cover! Shoulders down! There's a two count and a kick out as Edge survives.
And Undertaker seems to have regained his focus. Here is a man who can put a great deal of damage on the.
Great counter by the former world champion. Edge, can he get to a cover? Crawls to one, hooks the leg. World title on the line, and Undertaker kicked out before referee Charles Robinson could even get position.
Michael, for a great deal of the WrestleMania match, what we saw was Edge countering most of the Undertaker's big moves. It was obvious he'd studied the Undertaker. Will he have success employing the same strategy tonight at Backlash?
And this is where the so-called, self-proclaimed predator, Edge, comes so dangerous. He noticed the Undertaker's weakened back, and the ultimate opportunist looks for the opportunity as he hooks the leg, and Undertaker kicks out at two.
Michael, it's obvious to me that Edge has seen the opportunity. He is now targeting that lower back. He's like, you could refer to him as a predator last week on SmackDown. He's like a shark that smells blood in the water, and he's ready to attack.
The cunning and shrewd Edge could be in the driver's seat, wearing the world champion down. This could be that one opening that Edge needed in this match.
Throughout his career, as I mentioned, psychological dominance has been at the forefront of The Undertaker's game. Part of that dominance was he was seemingly able to take an unbelievable, an inhuman amount of punishment. But perhaps the tasks at hand, the grueling matches with Kane, with Festus, the two classic confrontations with Batista we saw at SmackDown, have taken their toll on the dead man.
Look at the look on the dead man's face. The Undertaker trying to power out of this predicament. The world champion realizes he's in dire straits, and he's turned the tables on Edge.
Raining big blows on the R-rated superstar.
What has the damage been done?
Michael, every one of The Undertaker's blows is thrown with bad intentions.
Wild right hand, Edge right back to the back.
He has an ability to focus in on any weakness and exploit it.
When is the last time you heard The Undertaker let out a groan like he just did?
It may be a first. I don't believe it has precedent.
Watch the look in the Undertaker's eyes here. And suddenly, the rated R superstar, one of the most controversial athletes in the history of World Wrestling Entertainment, could be closing in on his fifth world championship.
And Edge has to feel confident now. He's not intimidated by the dead man. Maybe he's thinking back to the times he had unprecedented success against The Undertaker.
Almost a camel clutch-like maneuver here. This works in the back, right?
He's putting lots of pressure. He's reaching up, pulling up on the chin, while putting his body weight, the bulk of his body weight, on The Undertaker's lower back. He's wearing down the dead man, setting him up for what he hopes to be sweet, sweet revenge and a new reign as WWE World Heavyweight Champion.
Come on.
Take everything The Undertaker has to somehow get himself out of this predicament.
Normally, Michael, this is used as a submission hold. I think it almost goes without saying you're just not going to see The Undertaker
give up here.
He is wearing him down. And where does The Undertaker find the strength to power up?
Undertaker did power up.
Almost powered up.
But Edge continued to have the wherewithal to keep himself connected to The Undertaker. Wrapped around The Undertaker's back, but as they get to the ropes, the break is ordered.
He ended up in that body scissor, putting more damage on the injured lower back of The Undertaker. Edge needs that. I'm sure he has a plan going right back to that modified camel clutch.
2 points here. The title will change hands if Undertaker does tap out, number one. Number two, you wear the back down, you take out so much of The Undertaker's arsenal. Last ride, choke slam, tombstone. He can't use his power game.
The Undertaker knows he's in a predicament that he needs to get out of using his body weight. 300 pounds of the dead man dropping right on Edge.
Great counter by the world champion, as desperation perhaps is setting in for the Phenom. Has to create separation between him and Edge. And here's that counter maneuver. Both men! Collision!
Ordinarily, in a two-person collision, The Undertaker's going to get the best of the deal, but not necessarily so here. He's been worn down to an extent that I have never seen.
You notice every time The Undertaker tries to just move any part of his body, a grimace takes over his face. And double kicks knock both men down. Again, Edge continuing to counter The Undertaker at almost every turn, much like at their epic match at WrestleMania.
There's that devastating boot, taking Edge right off his feet. Remember what's at stake. It's the World Heavyweight Championship. That's why these men are going to the extremes that they are.
I don't know if it was wise for Edge to try to exchange blows with The Undertaker.
Like I said, each one thrown with bad intentions. Undertaker. And Michael, while those punches may not mean the end, they are often the beginning of the end, where Undertaker can employ one of those incredible moves. The last
Well, the question. And Edge ducked out of the way. Ran into trouble. Undertaker, snake eyes. Bugasco, the world championship.
And a big elbow drop. Count it, Michael. One,
maybe
two.
Staying around. Kicks at it too. You gotta believe The Undertaker knew he needed that three count there. The longer this match goes with a back injury, the more it favors Edge.
I'm not sure, because it's been said, and many a superstar will attest to the fact that despite the punishment, The Undertaker seems to get stronger with time. He has an innate ability to take punishment and keep coming back for more. An ability the likes of which we've never seen.
You should know, you've been in epic battles with the man.
Sometimes, Michael Cole, the dead man truly does seem to be supernatural.
Edge is in trouble. Undertaker's hooked. Edge battling out. Almost as the last ride for the number one contender. Almost exhaustion seeming to creep into the body of the Phenom, the world champion. who doesn't often fly, but heads to the top rope here.
But when he does, he makes it. Whoa!
Right on the back. His spine smashing into the mat from the top rope. Edge looking to pick the bones. The ultimate opportunity. Two counters. He got it. No. Kick out at 2.5 by Edge. So close to the world
Watch
title.
Watch the big man getting way up in the air, which means he goes way down to the canvas. Almost like a gift from above. Edge could not have been anticipating The Undertaker taking flight, but he sure will take advantage.
Wait a second. Edge just grabbed the world title. He's got to be careful here. This could...
Maybe an attempt, a ploy.
Edge may have made a mistake. Went for the choke slam.
Oh!
Edge countered a second time. Oh! A Russian leg sweep. Again targets the back. Edge crawls to the cover. Hooks the leg. Will crown a new champion. No! Kick out. At 2.5 by the Phenom.
I know I'm new to SmackDown, Michael, but Edge may have The Undertaker's number here. He seems to be able to counter every one of The Undertaker's counter holds, just one step ahead of him in this human game of chess.
Edge has only lost to The Undertaker one time in his career, and Edge has been here for 10 years. That could be it. Undertaker, the cover.
One, two.
He's got it. Oh, Edge.
Foot on the ropes has saved the chances of the R-rated superstar. Do we see just a little bit of frustration sinking in onto the features of the Undertaker?
Undertaker says it's over now. Rest in peace, Edge.
Keep in mind, though, the words, I'm going to hurt you.
Well, the tombstone pile driver will hurt. With Edge hanging on for dear life, but the turnbuckle went off of the corner. And look at Edge. There is the ultimate opportunist. That is what we're talking about. Oh, and he ran into a clothesline.
Edge just rammed the Undertaker's lower back, that injured lower back, into the exposed steel underneath that turnbuckle, taking a tremendous effect on the dead man's lower back.
Look at this.
Oh, no.
Kurt Hawkins, Edge's running buddy. The referee never saw it. He was busy with the turnbuckle. A championship, that championship to the back of the skull of the Undertaker.
I understand the stakes are high, but I don't want to see
and
a championship match.
Edge is going to steal it. He's going to steal it on a kickout. Somehow the Undertaker kicked out before a three count. Edge thought he was going to take advantage of the opportunity again.
Michael, he simply draws on resources that most of us don't have.
Oh, but for a spear, countered into the DDT. Now it's Undertaker with not much left. Covers Edge. Kick out at 2.5.
I have to believe if Undertaker had had the strength to put his entire body weight on the R-rated superstar, we'd be seeing the bell ring, Undertaker victorious.
What a physical matchup between the world champion and the number one contender all over the world title.
No, come on.
Zack Ryder.
There's the Undertaker. Could it be last ride time?
Going for the last ride.
He's up. Counter. Sunset's covered.
He's got it. Edge's got it. Look at this.
He's got it off.
There it is.
He's got it off.
The lethal submission hold.
Michael Cole, he's got to tap. There's no escape. He needs to tap, and he needs to do it now to prevent serious, serious injury.
World title on the line. Will Edge tap out?
Edge just tapped. There's no shame in tapping.
It's locked in. Edge is fading. The world champion.
I cannot believe Edge has lasted that long, this long. There's a
good one. Edge taps out. Undertaker retains the world title.
And it's a relief to see the end has come. Wait, Michael, he seems to still have that hole locked in place.
The matchup is over. The matchup is over. And Undertaker still got this submission maneuver locked into place. Edge is fading. The evil Undertaker, as Edge's fiance, Vicky Guerrero, makes her way to the ring. Remember the Undertaker's words, Vic. I'm gonna hurt you.
The prophetic words. As much as Edge has done to to incite the wrath of the Undertaker, you have to wonder, have we seen the end or a shortening of what is and has been a great career?
I don't believe that anyone has ever been in that submission hold longer than Edge just was.
Well, I don't think the human body is made to withstand it. From what I can gather, that devastating hold affects the human body on two fronts. The shin bone pressing into the throat, acting as a suffocating maneuver, and the other leg coming down, putting an unbelievable amount of torque and pressure on the back of the head. We see the grim results of a hold that knows no equal.